Hi, my name is Christinos, and I would like to present the second part of our contribution, monitoring of water quality through low-cost tracking and crowdsourcing. In this part, I will focus on the tracking of test organisms. It is a common ecotoxicological approach to assess the impact of toxic substances using living animals. For example, the acute toxicity is or was often expressed in the LD50 value. That means the concentration where half of all test organisms are not surviving. But not only the short-term reactions or responses like dead or alive is of interest, also long-term effects, that means effects of ecological relevance like different growth rates or altered swimming behavior of test organisms can be observed and might be of interest. This integral and summed quality parameter are also applicable to check the drinking water quality. A lot of ecological or ecotoxicological studies had been done in the recent decades using or investigating the behavior of test organisms under different environmental conditions and in different treatments. In the following couple of minutes, we'll focus on aquatic zooplankton swimming in liquid test media, although everything can be transferred to other environments and organisms. Abnormal behavior of small water fleas had been shown to be an early and sensitive indicator. Abnormal behavior can be an altered mean swimming velocity or sporadic motions, as well as an increase in escape jumps. As a result of such tests, also commercial products like the toximeter TAF-TOX2 were produced and frequently applied to continuously control the water quality in water supply stations. We, however, set up our own system, which enables us to track the three-dimensional pathways of swimming zooplankton at a high temporal resolution. The hardware is on basis of a pre-existing commercial PIV system, hence with 4 megapixel 12-bit cameras and tele-eccentric lenses, it is somehow over-equipped. Regarding the software, we wrote our own tracking algorithm and code, which we would like to establish as an open source code and where we would be pleased if this can be applied for public health care. Before we will discuss the possibility to transfer the present to a low cost or a low tech system, I will briefly go into the steps of the tracking algorithm and method. At first, it is essential to capture some calibration images to determine the alignment of each camera in respect to the volume of interest, as well as to capture some background images. Then the raw images of the moving organisms will be recorded, and after this, the pre-processing provides the identification of moving objects in the raw images. In a third step, coordinates and probably sizes will be scaled and rotated to the reference system. After scaling and rotating of the object coordinates, the most difficult step follows: the assignment of the objects in one frame to the identical objects in another frame. As I tried to visualize with this sketch, it is not straightforward just to take the nearest neighbors, as you can see, for two pairs of states. With a constrained assignment algorithm, however, it is possible to compute the three-dimensional coordinates out of multiple camera perspectives and also to track individuals over time of the recorded sequences. Let me shortly present an outlook how we can transfer our system and method to a low-cost solution. The most important requirement is the vessel with the test organisms, where we know how they react on external stressors like toxic substances. The necessary hardware of this low-cost motion tracking device strongly depends on the test organisms itself. If it is essential to observe the motion or any other characteristic like color,
in three or more dimensions, one needs at least four perspectives. The cameras can be very simple, like webcams or cameras in smartphones, but should be triggered simultaneously. Last but not least, there's a huge need for manuals and guidelines, because although the cameras might be simple, the entire method is not. This should be underlined regarding the motion analysis, as well as in respect to use such a method for crowdsourcing.
So, thank you for your attention, and I'm looking forward to the discussion during the flash meeting.